So up to 27, is there any problem? Up to 27, is there any problem? Okay, Amit, anybody? Anybody up to 27? Okay, so we move on. Okay, now, similar to what we discussed right in the very first class, the delta star conversion. Here it will be simpler because here it is balanced, so all the loads are same. With delta, then all the loads are same. Star, then all the loads are same. Right? How to do it? See, 28 and 29 are okay. I will not tell you. See, read the equations. Any question you ask. 28 and 29. We have simply used the results which we have seen earlier. Yes, but careful about V phase and VL and IL and I phase. And which one is what? This one is for the star, okay, and this one is for delta. So we have simply used the relationship of V phase and VL, line voltage and phase voltage for voltage, and line current and phase current for the delta and star connections. They are not same. Look carefully. They are not same. So is 28 and 29 okay? This is for the star, where V phase is VL by root 3 and I phase is IL. This is for the delta, where V phase is VL, I phase is IL by root 3. And just compare 28 and 29, we see this. Is it okay or I need to say, or I need to explain something? 28, 29. Really doubt you can ask how, what, why this is. Okay, anybody else? Okay, anybody else? Great. So if 28 and 29 okay, 30 will also be okay. If z delta is equal to 3 times z star y, then z y would be 1/3 z. Okay. Oh yes, before we end, in the first class we had done the delta star conversion. So can anyone compare this equation 30 with the equations we had seen in that class? Are they same or are they different? What was the formula? Delta star conversion. Like I have the delta form. What is the corresponding star form? So homework for this class is you compare 30 with those equations and conclude whether they are the same or different or something else. Okay. Okay. So over the weekend you think about it, that whether this equation we derived just now is in accordance with those equations. Fine. So think about it. And if they match, then why they match? If they don't match, then why they are not matching? Think about this. If you are able to find the answer, very good. Otherwise, I do. Okay. Now, we are using the same value of Z phase in a delta connected way and in the star connected way. And we would like to find out what is the power delivered in each case, right? So for star connected, we can say this. Absolutely, Oniji, thank you. Correctly, be careful. No. It doesn't match dimensionally, right? That is equal to r square by 3r is what? Rakodip? What is r square by 3r? R by 3? Yes? Find the similarity. See now, compare what you have written with 30. Exactly. Now compare this with this. Because we had throughout assumed that all the loads are the same. In this course, we will only deal with balanced load. Unbalanced load, we are not discussing, right? Okay, now back here. So, I for a star connected load, I phase is V phase by Z phase. That is equal to VL by root 3 Z phase because V phase is VL by root 3. And IL is same as I phase, that is this. So what is power? We saw it previously. Change, get this equation. 33 is okay. Or any doubt, I will give you. I will ask. 31, 32, 33. Are they fine? If not, then tell me which equation is you are having difficulty. I will. Okay, Amit, thank you. Anybody else? 31, 32, 33. Any doubts? Okay, Ishika. Right. Now for delta connected load 34, 35, 36. Delta connection to recall that VL is V phase and IL is root 3 times I phase. So 34, 35, 36, check. All okay. So the power for the delta connected load is same, 3 phase, 3 times the power of the star connected load. P delta is 3 times P1. Clear? 36 is clear, right? So with this we come to the end of the first part of this chapter. Okay, the second part is about power measurement, that we'll do on Tuesday. Now let us solve two problems and then let's solve. Okay, so the first part of this chapter is over. That from Tuesday we'll do the second. So there are two problems. What is this one? Three equal impedances, each of 8 plus J10 ohms, are connected in. First part is this one, relationship between VL and V phase. What is VL, what is V phase, what is IL, what is I phase, relationship between them. Okay. The second part is about how to measure power in a three phase system. Okay. That we will start from Tuesday. So now at this moment, we will do two problems and then the class. Right. So see the problem. First problem, three equal impedances each of 8 plus J10 ohms are connected in a star. This is further connected to a 440 volt 50 hertz 3 phase supply. Calculate A phase voltage, B phase angle, C phase current, D line current, E active power and F reactive. Is the problem okay? Clear what they have asked and what is given? So there are three impedances. There are three impedances. Of course, they are same because they must be realistic. Each of them are 8 plus J10 ohms. Each of them. This is also this. This is also this. This is also this. And they are connected to a 440 volt 50 hertz supply. So this is the line voltage. So line voltage is 440 volt 50 hertz. So what is 440 volt? RMS value or peak value? What is 440 volt? Is it peak or RMS? Exactly, very good. RMS. Not, sorry, my mistake. It's not angle. Angle is 0. This is not 50. 50 is the frequency, not the angle. Angle we consider 0 degree, okay? The frequency is 50 hertz, so not the angle. So this is correct. It's not correct. So F is 50 hertz. So VL is given. And Z phase is given. So what is V phase? Tell me. At least the formula will tell me. So what is V phase? And this is star connected. So what is V phase? Tell me. What is V phase? Very good. VL by root 3. So what is this value? exactly right. So this is this value. This is the answer of the first part. Second phase angle, Z is this, converting into polar form, okay, and get this, this is the phase angle, correct. Phase angle is tan inverse of exactly right. Right, so if you use a calculator and check, you will get this value. B part is fine, phase angle. What is C? Phase current. How to find phase current, anybody? How to find phase current? Yes, but we don't know IL. You are right, I agree with you. I phase equal to IL, correct. But what is IL? We don't know IL. Yes, Amit, very good. V phase by Z phase. V phase is this one. We calculate it. Z phase is this one. So we divide. Okay. D is line current. Now we use opposite formula, I phase equal to IL. Now we know I phase, so IL is same. Up to D, okay. Right? E, active power, apply the formula. Root 3 VL IL cos phi. VL we know, IL we know, cos phi we know. But if I we know, so cos phi is the current type. Correct. Reactive power, same but sign. So this problem is okay. Anything you want to ask? Just use the formula, nothing. Just put the formula, put them in the formulas. We discuss, get the answers. As simple as that. Good. So what about this problem? Give it a read. Here the frequency of 50 hertz, the frequency angular omega is given. Okay, 800 radians. So the load is now a bit complicated. There is an inductors in series with a parallel combination of a resistor and a capacitor. So our load this time, it looks like this. So we have a an inductor that is 50 millihenry that we have connected in series with a parallel combination. So this is 50 microfarad. This is how much? Sorry, 50 ohms. So what is the first step? So this is our load. This is our Z and we have connected this in delta. So this is our Z and each Z is this. Inductive reactance nikalna hoga, Z nikalna hoga. Yes, so inductive is nikalna hai. So what is the first step? Before we do anything, what is the first step? Omega is 800 radians per second. It's also given. It's also given. Okay. What is the first step? Yes, right. XL is omega n. Absolutely agree with you. So XL equal to omega n. That is 800 times 50 times 10 to the power minus 3. That is equal to how much? Right. Sure. Absolutely sure. Right. We will find the impedance. This is Z we have defined. Right. So we have, I have done this. Let's see that omega XL is omega n, as we said. So 800 times 50 millihenry. So this, so 40 ohms. XC is okay. Using the formula. Capacitor was 50 microfarad. So 1 by omega C. Omega is 800. So ZPH is the parallel combination of this C and R. That is in series with the L. See, that is what we have done. Parallel of R and C, that is in series with the L. Okay. So can verify this calculation. Correct. How this is coming? Right. So Z phase calculation is clear. Impedance of each phase. How we are getting Z phase is fine for all. Okay. Now we use the formulas again. For delta connected load, VA, V phase is VL. So if V phase is, sorry, VL is 550 volt, V phase will be the same. So what is I phase? V phase by Z phase. Use the formula, get the answer. C. IL and V I phase. IL is root 3 I phase. Getting the answer. Then D. F. Just use the formula. Anything you want to say about that? Haan, absolutely. Sir, diya hua hai, formula use kar liya. Bas. Aur kuch nahi. So any questions regarding so far what we have calculated, what we have discussed three phase? From Tuesday we will start with the power measurements. Okay, using 2 watt meter. And are you familiar with watt meter? Are you familiar with watt meter? How a watt meter works? Good. So that makes my job easier. No, not electricity meter. Not the meters you see at in the home. Not those things. Though they measure elect energy, not power. But here we use the watt meter that measures power. Note carefully, in the meters you have in your home, they are watt hour meter, not watt meter. Okay? Watt hour and watt are different. Kilowatt hour is not power. More than enough, no problem. Or because the kilowatt hour is the energy, not power. Exactly. But here we will not measure energy, we will measure power. And we will use a watt meter. Okay. So are you familiar with the watt meter? Have you seen the watt meter in your electrical lab? That's what I am asking. No. Okay, so first we discuss watt meter, that can. Okay. I cannot see. I can Google that. Simply Google the term. You will know what a watt meter is. What is that? Okay. It is like how much power you are consuming. Okay, not energy, power, right? In our homes, we pay for the energy, not for the power. Okay, they are related, no doubt, but. We are measuring, that is what that is measuring is the energy, not the power. affiliate there, we get it, but not the same thing. So you go after this class, you go to the where the meter is and see what is measuring, what is written there. Okay, that's the homework. After the class ends, just go to the place where the meter is and just see what is written. Okay then, and if there is no question, then I am ending the class. Right? So you just read about what meter, at least reading from Wikipedia. Okay, just get some idea, and we will meet again on Tuesday. Okay, good night, thank you very much. Okay, so please cut off the class. Okay, thank you.